Hey everyone, my name's Mayuko, and welcome back to my channel where we talk about tech, career, and life. So this is part two of a kind of series, I guess, where I critique my own resumes from the past. In the first one, I reviewed my very first resume from college, like pre any work experience, pre any real programming experience. And in this one, I'm gonna review the resume that got me like my first real tech company internship. So actually, when I was originally filming my resume critique video, it was one long 30-minute video where I critique all of the resumes, but it's a little bit too long for me, like 30 minutes of resumes, and so I decided to break it up into three parts. So this is part two of three. Again, you might be watching this video because number one, you're looking for inspiration and advice for your own resumes, or number two, you're just nosy and you're curious and you wanna know what my resume looked like. Both are fine reasons for watching my video, so I hope you stick around to the end and I hope you enjoy. So without further ado, here's my resume. I think I wrote this in like fall of 2012, so it would have been fall of my junior year in college. The first thing that stuck out to me is like, the margins are so small. Like when I print it, my name gets cut off. So I probably should not have such tiny margins. I think I did this at the time because I was like, I have so much information, I have no way to fit it. So let's just like decrease the margins. As you'll see as I go through this, I definitely could have fit everything if I just was more concise. And then I wouldn't have to have these like tiny margins where like even things at the bottom got cut off here. So next is the objective section: to obtain an internship in which I can assist on software engineering projects using my technical background as well as organizational and leadership skills. I feel like it basically says the same thing as my previous objective, just like a little bit more specific and maybe a little bit more elegant too. So the next part I put education, but I actually think that should go like way down at the bottom because I had relevant experience at the time and that should be the next thing. But let's dive into the education section for a bit. So I got realistic apparently, and now I say that my degree is expected June 2014, which is, yeah, I was like, oh right, I'm actually supposed to graduate in the summer like everybody else. I also fixed the BS computer science, and then I put technical skills and coursework, which at the time was important because it indicated to recruiters what classes I had already taken, and things like data structures and object-oriented design and algorithms are very important for internships. So I actually probably would have put those on the left side and then put the Linux and Java stuff on the right side. Like if I were to order it, I probably would have done data structures and object-oriented design, algorithms, my programming languages, and then Linux, Mac OS X, Windows. I actually maybe would have completely gotten rid of the operating systems part because I wasn't getting a job related to operating systems, so it doesn't really matter. Next is the related experience and projects section, which I should have just called it experience. First up is the internship that I had at Celluride Science Grail Mooncam. Again, just a little bit of my language is not as concise as it could be. Instead of saying led the development of, I should have just said developed. So it says that I developed a Java applet intended to educate students worldwide on the technologies used by NASA's Grail spacecraft and of the Mooncam project. Reading this now, I feel like this was the very first like product that I worked on, which is interesting because I'm a product engineer. I really enjoy doing product. And at this job, this was the time where I was both the engineer, designer, and product manager for this game. So reading it now, I'm kind of like, oh, like this is where it all started, like that game that I made. That's kind of all I have for that section. So moving on, this was for my internship at the UCSD Department of Medicine. I have like a thing about like assisted in the creation of an analysis tool related to iDash for actual research use, but that's basically describes the project that I had below. So I don't think that whole sentence was necessary. And then I say like I am implemented the visualization layer of microRNA sequence data analyzer by using various interactive technologies. I would have just gotten rid of the by using various interactive technologies because I literally go into what those things are in the next line. And then I was also the research project assistant there for a while. And again, this sentence, assisted program manager and related documentation, organization, and planning for division's grants. I just would have been like what? Like what did you do? Like more specifically. And then the next section, I highlight a project that I did for one of my classes. And instead of saying that I did this at UCSD Department of CSE, I probably just would have put the XFit CrossFit Android application as the header. And if I wanted to keep more consistent with the previous format of saying company slash project and then the role, then I probably would have set my role as project manager, software engineer. And again, just like, it's not really specific. Like, I led a team of developers, I developed the user interface of the application. Like, what part of the user interface did I work on? What exactly did I do to lead a team of developers? And I remember I did things like take notes at meetings, host weekly meetings, check in on status updates, identify blockers. So those are the things that I think would have been really useful to understand, like, what kind of project manager was I. And then next, I have leadership experience. I think kind of the same stuff as last time for this whole part of, like, what did you actually do? It says, like, delegated tasks to cabinet members and overlooked all internal and external functions. But I would have wondered, like, but what exactly did you do? Like, were there any results? How many people were involved? How much work was involved? Because these things are like, you could write about this whether you were really involved in your role or not, or whether you were good at this role or not. And I would have liked to have gotten more of a signal. I mean, I just straight up didn't write a description for, like, my vice president of internal affairs or publicity chair stuff for this one. And then underneath that, I have skills, which kind of talk a lot about leadership qualities, communication skills, working in an organized and timely manner, which, you know, was really brought over from my previous resume. But I kind of maybe would have gotten rid of this entirely, because if I embellished everything else, like if I made all of this part more descriptive and talked specifics about what I did, then that would come through no matter what. And then I would have had more space on the page, wouldn't have to do this weird margin thing that I did, and I would have been able to fit everything without needing to compromise the quality. So yeah, kind of similar feedback as the last resume. I just have a lot more stuff. Like, I've had a lot more experience at this point, and so I was really trying to be like, look at all this experience I have, by really filling the page. But really, it's not about quantity of information, and it's more the quality. And I think there would have been some really good opportunities to do so here. At the end of the day, though, this was the resume that got me an internship at Intuit, which led to my first full-time job. And so again, this resume did its job and was good at the time. And I am grateful to it, and thank you, old resume. All right, everybody, thanks so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed it. Maybe you learned a thing or two about what to put and what not to put in a resume, and maybe you also enjoyed just being a little bit nosy and looking at what my past resume looked like. And I wanted to say a big thank you to NordVPN for sponsoring today's video. In college, when I wasn't writing a resume or in class or doing programming assignments, I was most certainly on Netflix. And why stop at watching content in one country when you can unlock Netflix and other streaming websites in many other countries using NordVPN? It's also really important to use a VPN if you're on a public Wi-Fi, especially at school or maybe at a cafe when you're studying. And NordVPN protects your data when you're traveling or in public. You can have up to 6 simultaneous connections, and there's no data logging. And it also works in China. It's really safe to use. They have double data encryption for increased anonymity. There's also 24/7 customer support and a 30-day money-back guarantee. So get 70% off of NordVPN. That's only $3.49 a month, and you get an additional month free when you go to nordvpn.com/hellomayuko or use the coupon code HELLOMAYUKO. That's nordvpn.com/hellomayuko or use the coupon code HELLOMAYUKO. The information is also in the description box down below. Thanks again to NordVPN for sponsoring, and check out part one of the resume series right here and be on the lookout for part 3. And that's it. I hope you all have a great day wherever you are. Bye.